there. Mahirap.
Pwede nabili nga, hindi nga lang
na. There are so many possibilities actually. It, pwedeng simulated sale, pwedeng pwedeng fictional siya, pwedeng totoo, pero hindi lang niya kabisado. So yun ang sinasabi lang namin. There are many questions raised by that are not, kumbaga, hindi siya in accord with human experience, diba? Alam naman natin yun kasi siguro lahat sa atin.
Pero kaduda-duda lang. Bakit hindi pa
niya? Kaduda-duda lang. Medyo parang nakapagtaka.
Ako, ang sabihin ko is, yung testigo premisinta para patunayan na yung properties na yon ay hindi intentionally or hindi talaga kinailangan i-deklara. Bagamat nasa pangalan pa nila, hindi kinakailangan i-deklara kasi pagmamayari na nung pinsan ni Chief Justice. Yun ang dahilan bakit siya premisinta. So that the Chief Justice did not violate because it already belongs to his cousin. Yun ang dahilan bakit siya premisinta. At ang judgment namin po dyan, based on the cross-examination, hindi ho nalilipat yung titulo for 20 years. Yung real estate taxes ay nasa pangalan pa rin po. Yung notaryo po ay peke. Ang ibig sabihin po, kung ano man ang purpose na dinala siya doon, hindi po siya nagkaroon ng gamit. Because based on what has been shown to us, it is simply unacceptable that for somebody who says na hindi niya inilipat dahil hindi niya ma-afford ang transfer taxes, yet he doesn't know how much these transfer taxes are. Paano mo sasabihin na hindi ko kayang bilhin itong sasakyan na ito eh? Na hindi mo pa tinatanong kung magkano yung sasakyan and yet you make that judgment. So what we're simply saying is, kung ano man ang dahilan kung bakit siya premisinta, it was not able to establish that the property has in fact been transferred. In fact, kung may questions pang yung lumalabas dyan, para may katanungan, totoo kaya yung deal of absolute sale o simulated ba ito? It's still in the name of the Chief Justice and his wife. Mukhang nasa pagmamayari pa rin nila ito.
Ang tanong ko lang, Sir, itong witness na ito, si Mr. Vicente, sa tingin ba ninyo parang robot lang siya? Kung anong idikta sa kanya, yan ang sabihin niya.
Yan ang paborito sagutin ni Deputy Speaker Erin Tanyada, pero wala dito, ano ha? Compliment yun ha? Hindi ko po alam kung siya po ay robot o hindi po natin, pero malinaw po para sa atin na meron silang blood relationship with the Chief Justice. There are questions pertaining to the deed of absolute sale which was notarized by a fake notary. So, the title has not been transferred. Ang tawag po natin dyan sa batas, these are practically badges of fraud. Na parang nagdadala sa atin sa conclusion na kung ano man ang dahilan bakit siya premisinta, based on the cross-examination, they were not successful in showing that the property is owned by him.
At saka kung robot siya, parang, ewan ko, mahina yung baterya, o kaya parang mahina yung software, baka hindi pa na-upgrade, no? Na-update, kasi parang may pagkakamali dun sa mga ibang sa cross-examination na ilabas ko.
Yeah, Christine Herrera from Manila Standard.
Needs no introduction.
Yeah. How would you explain, can I go back to the South End, how would you explain that the prosecution failed to present evidence on the Chief Justice's Corona's South End from 2001 to 2005? Because Kim Henares only presented South End from 2006 to 2010, and then she said that the Supreme Court or the Chief Justice failed to file his salad. And now the defense is showing us that there is salad filed from 2001 to 2005. How would you explain that?
Let me...
Was it deliberate?
No. Let me correct the question. What Kim Henares said, we have the salad. We were able to present the salad of the Chief Justice all the way from 1992 up to 1998. And beginning 2001 all the way up to 2010, yung galing sa Supreme Court, yung simula 2003. What Kim Henares testified was the alpha list. Wala yung alpha list from 2002, when he started joining half part of that year, until 2005. The first alpha list na meron ang Ang VAR on record is starting 2006. So,
well, the defense said that they filed.
Yeah, it's there. It's there, no? Pero there's really no significance, no? As far as we are concerned, the AFA list only speaks about how much taxes were actually paid for that year for every given individual. So
but that's exactly what you want to prove, that the Chief Justice is not capable of purchasing all these properties because he's got no money to buy those.
No, the taxes can only be used as a basis to determine his income. Pero we never said that he did not have any income for 2002. 03-04. In fact, we said that let's even compute on the basis of his maximum salary in 2010 as a Chief Justice. Gamitin na natin yun na kunwari yun ang kanyang kinita all the way up to 2003. Because wala tayo nung alpha list, it would still not be sufficient. So, I think there's really nothing significant as far as producing the alpha list is concerned. Kung meron lang siyang na-establish is that according to the Supreme Court, they filed their... The AFA list kasi is essentially the income tax returns. Pero binubuo lang siya if you have one employer. So what it only established is that the Supreme Court says it filed, but the BIR says it did not. But that's not really our concern as far as the impeachment is concerned.
So what is your total now? Because the defense said it's 21.5 billion. What is yours?
Well, they said it's 21.5. We will have to validate that on cross-examination. But like I said, even assuming, just on the basis of all the expenses that he has, just on one condominium, he's spending already 21,000 on condominium juice. Corriente, yung mga iba pang condominium juice, pagkain. We were unfortunately unable to present the barongs. He had two barongs made in June of 2010, 25,000 pesos each. So, hindi na ho namin na-presenta yon. Pero ibig ko sabihin, let's even assume that he saves half of that, 10 million, which is unlikely. He was able to purchase real properties amounting to 32 million. Real properties pala. With 10 million, I don't think you can buy 32 million. And neither can you, may 31 million in cash pa, nadagdag. May 37 million pa in cash na terminate noong 2011. Meron pang dollar accounts na hindi po mabuksan. So, tingin po namin talagang kahit paanong sabihin nila, mahihirapan talaga sila punuan yan. So, we will wait for all the sources of income that they will show.
Tsaka, Christine, ano, follow-up. You're saying that our allegation is wala siyang pambili. Actually, it's not only na wala siyang pambili. Ang sinasabi rin namin, hindi niya deklarado. Kung meron siyang pambili, hindi niya deklarado na meron siyang binili at meron siyang pinagkunan para pambili. So yun ang follow-up doon.
The subpoenas were actually issued. No, I'm sorry. Yes, they were issued, but we did not present anymore because...
After the Palio.
So yung Pal kasi, hindi na pinayagan yung Pal Platinum where he traveled for free on business class at least 8 times internationally in a span of 6 months. Nung hindi na namin na-present yun, hindi na rin namin present yung iba because we were certain that it was going to be disallowed.